Hello guys, this is silverFoxA, and in this particular video I'm going to share with you how to upload your website or make it live. Before we get into uploading our website, we need to get a domain. You can get it from any domain provider, for example Godaddy. In this case I got it from Bigrock, and we'll let you know how to link it with DigitalOcean. Now what is DigitalOcean? It's a cloud infrastructure provider where you get your own system to play around with. It's pretty good for a developer where everything can be maintained and easily customized based on the requirement. It's more like building up your own house from scratch. That feels really cool actually when you get to know how to work around with this content. Okay, so this is the console I got from my domain provider, which briefs me all about the domain that I got and all the name servers and everything. But before tweaking around with the name server, we have to create a droplet, and before that let us log into the system. Okay, once you're logged into the system, you get to see a dashboard, the basic one, and you'll get to see something called droplet. Now they maintain a concept called droplet where each droplet is more like a web hosting for you. Okay. Here you get to see something called distribution, then one click apps, right? The first one, distribution, is nothing but you get separate OS where you can get one of these and then start implementing your solution, like keep installing stuff. Or else one thing you can get is one click application where everything is configured by default for you. This LAMP, for an example, it has a PHP, MySQL, Apache server, and those things are already installed on Ubuntu 16.04. okay, and then we have this MongoDB, PHP MyAdmin, and WordPress. Let's assume you want to make a WordPress blog, and you just click on it, okay, and everything comes by default for you. For our particular project, we'll be going with PHP MyAdmin because it has the PHP MyAdmin console configured by default. Once you're done with which app you want, you'll be asked to select a billing cycle. So for this, let's just go off with $5 per month. That's the base that they charge, and it's pretty good actually. Seeing the SSD and all the stuff, so let's assume you want to go for higher memory or CPU, you can select from one of these options available for you. Okay, now it comes to data center region. When you're talking about a data center region, you need to understand that the code base are residing under this particular region, right? Okay, now let's assume I'm from India, okay, and if I select New York or anything as such apart from Bangalore, the latency might vary, so the time to first byte will increase in that case. So I'll just select with Bangalore because it is my nearby data center and the latency won't be that much. Okay, once you are done with that, let's go off with private networking. So I need my droplets to interact with them. Backup, in case if you are planning for a backup, like keep backing up your data, that will cost you some 20% extra. Then IPv6 and monitoring user data, we don't check it now. This is SSH key, we'll talk about this later. Okay, let's just get started with the host name. Okay, we're all set. Let's hit create. This will create the droplet for us and do minor configuration and adding some default configuration files and everything that's required. And once it completely created, we'll get our email which will tell us the password and all the stuff, credentials basically. So now we need to change the name server for our domain under the domain provider. Once we get this from here, DigitalOcean. Okay, this is the IP that we got. Let's go into networking. Here we are configuring the domain or else the URL stuff. Okay, let's just go to the domain provider, copy the link, the URL. Okay, this is our domain. We'll paste it here and create a new domain.
Okay, so let's just configure the NS setting, DNS setting. Let's copy it from here. Go to the domain provider, click or find out where your name server is, and let's configure. So here we need 3 NS records, okay? Not more than that. Okay, let's just update the NS server. Don't need that. Let's update. Okay, once this is updated, we'll just configure a few other content here. First, we'll just give add the red, that is coming to the domain, the base one, right? The thing, and then we'll tell them to go to this particular droplet, right? When someone clicks for the URL flowerdecorator.in, it will go to that particular droplet. Okay, apart from this, we need to ensure that if someone clicks or else types in www.flowerdecorator.in, this would also be redirected to this particular droplet. So for that, we'll go to CNAME record, create a CNAME record there. We just need to type in www. Okay, rest it will configure itself, and we'll just have to put the host name. That's it. Right, we're done. Okay, so everything is done and ready. Cool, right? Now let's just check if it's working fine. Okay, sorry. Okay, now it might not show up because our DNS configuration change takes somewhere around 24 to 48 hours, but there's a tweak to it. You can either use Tor browser or just try to change the network, the one that you're currently on. That does the trick. Okay, let's just see if it works under incognito mode. Okay, it doesn't. It's running the default page. Let's wait for the Tor browser. So this is type VPN. Cool, right? So it's working. Our Apache server is installed, and you can check the PHP my admin. It will by default be configured for us as we have clicked the one click app. It won't show up because the JS is blocked. Cool. Okay, so let's get back to clicking. Okay, there's few more things remaining. Let's go to droplet. Now they have already mailed us the credentials to access our droplet. I'll show you how to access the droplet in this video itself. Okay, let's go to, okay, in order to access the droplet, you can either commit from the console, the DigitalOcean console, or else you can use terminal. I would prefer going via terminal because the web-based console is damn laggy. Doesn't like it anymore. Okay, type in SSH and we're accessing as root user the IP that we copied. Okay, this is our droplet IP. So, but we need the email password. Yeah, copy the password. They'll ask you for the current. Okay, they'll. Yes, they'll ask you for the password. Just paste it. Done. Okay, now this again they are asking for the current password, don't get confused. Type it in. Okay, now enter your new password. Oops, okay, let's try again. Okay, cool. So we are in. Okay, just a second. Yippee, we are in.
Let's check what all they gave us by default. Okay, let's go to var, the default directory. So this HTML directory is what has been configured for us. We can change it. I'll show you in the next video. Like we can create subdomains and all the stuff. So this file that I will show you in the next video, how to upload the files and the subdomains. We'll do it all together. Please share the video and subscribe to my channel if you liked the video and was informative enough for you. Thank you.